painted. Hey, what's up everyone, and welcome to Luigi's Mansion, a GameCube launch title released in 2001. Wow, this game is 14 years old. That is insane. Let's hit start. I'm pretty excited for this game, to be honest. I have no save files here. I've never played this on this Wii before. Let's go ahead and take a look at our options right here. We have sound, rumble, controls, brightness. View a Pikmin movie. We're not gonna view the Pikmin movie. Let's just go ahead and jump into file one, and I believe we're gonna be starting off with a cutscene. So let's go. And you may notice there, actually, right beneath where it says which file would you like to load, welcome to your mansion. Wait for it. Welcome to our mansion. Let's go. Alright, here we are, inside the mansion. Now, right off the bat, Luigi's Mansion is not your typical Mario game. You do not jump when you hit A. Luigi actually calls out Mario. A is the Mario button. It also allows him to hump cabinets and make things come out of them and stuff like that. Pressing B turns off your flashlight. He will always have the flashlight on, and you'll see why in a bit. You can also angle the flashlight up and down using the C-stick. This is how you basically control it. You move around with the control stick, of course. I'm trying to figure out if anything else has any controls yet. I don't believe so. Mario. So I believe what we're supposed to do is actually go ahead and head up here. So let's do that. Mario! Mario. Oh. Spooky. What was the spooky? What's in here? Nothing. Anything in this door? This door is also locked. This is spooky. Nothing seems to be happening in this mansion right now. What's going on? Nope, let me leave. No, come on, let me out. No, that key came out of the friggin' sky and just floated around. Let me out of the house. I can't get... Okay, Mr. Key. I guess we have a key now. And this key is gonna go ahead and open up this door, I believe. I think it's this door. We're about to find out.
Ouch. Oh, I sure do take a lot of knocks in this line of work. I'm getting too old for this ghost-catching tomfoolery.
Oh, yeah.
Anyway, nice to meet you. I'm Professor Egad. This house, I swear it seems to have more ghosts every day. What's a young fellow like you doing around here, anywho? Uh-oh, this looks ugly. All right, youngster, look lively. Follow me, post haste. So, your name's Luigi. I think our paths were destined to cross. Well met, Luigi. Hmm? Where's this, you ask? Why, this cozy quarters are where I d- pff, crap. Why, these cozy quarters are where I do my ghost studying. Professor Egad's Ghost Research Laboratory. The lab, if you're of a shortening mind. You won this mansion in a contest you didn't even enter? Sounds pretty fishy to me. So you believe the mansion actually exists then? Strange. I've been living here since I was a lad of 20 or so, and I'll tell you, that mansion appeared just a few days ago. The spirits have fooled you. I don't know if it's just a dream, an illusion, or what. Oh god. What all, but I surely wouldn't be too happy winning a haunted house. Now that I get a look at you, I just recalled. A guy with a red hat, kind of like yours, went up to the mansion without even stopping to chat, and he never returned. Was he a dream too? What? That guy was your brother? Oh no, that's horrible. He wouldn't stand a chance against those ghosts without my help. You have to go after him. Here's the plan. I'll teach you to deal with goats so you can rescue your brother, Luigi. I think I just said goats.
Okay, so this is gonna basically show us the controls. We can change between standard and sidestep. Sidestep is not something I actually like to use. So I'm gonna be sticking with standard. All it changes is that you move Luigi side to side. L button, shoot out fire, water, or ice. I'm not going to be covering just yet. That is something that happens a little bit later into the game. The flashlight thing I explained, A I explained. X and Y we'll be getting into in a moment, and probably Z. And also Y, because there's going to be a tutorial. Now, because we're on this screen, if we stay on this screen for 3 minutes, some secret music will start to play. So I'm going to go ahead and cut to when that happens. That right there was Totaka's song. For those of you who don't know what that is, it's in many games. In fact, it was in Pikmin 2 when I did that. The music, the guy who made the music for the game, the games he works on, he tends to put his song hidden in them, and this is obviously one of them because that was his song. Anyway,
that's the vacuum cleaner I engineered to catch ghosts. I call it, this is genius, the Poltergust 3000. It can suck up all kinds of things. Let it rip. Use the R button to vacuum and the C stick to change your direction.
Oh, he's wanting me to do it right now. So, this is what I was basically explaining before, except before it was with the, flashlight.
No matter how strong you think your brother is, ghosts are mysterious beings. They can't be caught using conventional means. So you'd better use this. It's the only way to foil them. This is the only thing they fear. Or something to that effect. Well, how's about we start your training? Ghosts seem to like darkness, and they avoid the light. So if you hit them with a flashlight beam all of a sudden, you can stun them momentarily. Then, it's vacuuming time. When you see your chance, hold down the R button and tilt the control stick in the opposite direction. Just give it a try. You'll learn more that way than just listening to me yap about it.
So, we're always gonna be in the dark. You gotta hold B to turn off your flashlight. Oh, wait.
Remember, as soon as you see a ghost's heart, that's your chance to vacuum him up.
Look at him doing his little punches.
While vacuuming, tilt the control stick in the opposite direction to bring him in.
So there's gonna be one spawning right here, we're just gonna turn around to him, flash the flashlight, and then start sucking in. Like so, using the R button, and that is how you kill the ghosts.
When that surprise ghost heart appears, vacuum it with the R button and the control stick. Tilt the control stick in the direction opposite the ghost.
Alright, let's get another guy. Boop. And then just suck him in, tilt the control stick away from him, and that is how you do that.
You have to get as close as you can before flashing the light. Surprise them with the light when they get close. Pow, pow. The more the better, got it?
So, now he's gonna send two of them at us. We can move away. Move around a little bit. Once we've done this, we can actually get two at once, and it is possible to get large numbers of ghosts at once.
Hey kid, shape up. You can't go looking for your brother the way you're carrying on. There, here they come.
What is that supposed to mean? I've been doing considerably well. Give me that. Did I just screw up by flashing my flashlight on them? Can I not get them anymore?
Catching ghosts means using the flashlight and the Poltergust 3000 as a team. You get me, young fella? That'll do.
Okay, I could have got those five, but I screwed it up.
Well, how many did you get? Five ghosts, huh? You're getting the hang of it, Luigi.
It is possible to get all of them. I just didn't realize that the flashlight was gonna activate on those first three.
Fine, fine. Looks like you worked up quite a sweat there. How about a little cool down in the gallery? I'm quite proud of it, you know.
Yeah, why not?
Off we go.
May as well show this off. You're not talking? He's not talking. So this is the gallery. At the moment, there's pretty much nothing we can do in here. You'll see right here on the walls that there are, little paintings, or what where paintings should be. So we'll be getting to that in a bit there. They're all over these walls. There's a special room back here. If we go through here, you'll see a giant golden room with a whole lot of nothing in it at the moment. This is not gonna be relevant for a little while, but this is Professor Egad's gallery, and he wanted to show it off, so I can't stop him. Alright, what do you got to say, bro?
Are you done appreciating art for today, Luigi?
Where am I?
This is the gallery. This is where I hang all my paintings. Ghost paintings, that is. When I was young, I designed a machine to turn ghosts into paintings, and have traveled the world collecting them. Oh, it was glamorous, I tell you. Well then, now I have to tell you a horrifying story. The last ghost I caught was number 22, Boolossus. But there are lots of Boos, and King Boo rallied them to take revenge upon me. They used my machine to free Boolossus from the painting. And then they went and turned all my other portraits back into ghosts too. As if that weren't enough, they built a mansion in front of my lab in the space of a single night. And then they all hid inside, if I told anybody else this stuff, they'd probably have me committed. I'm sure my portrait ghosts are somewhere inside the mansion. I just have to get them back.
So, now you know the plot of Luigi's Mansion, other than we have to find Mario. What else you got to say? What is a Gibi horror? A Gibi horror?
I designed the Game Boy Horror as a communications terminal. It has all sorts of functions. For example, you can press the Z button to see a list of the items you've picked up. Give it a try after you get some coins. Of course, you'll be able to see portrait ghost there once you capture some. You can also use the Y button to display a map of the mansion. The display will color the rooms as you visit them. Check the map if you ever get lost. Got all that, Sonny?
Yeah. Alright, let's press Z. This shows us our items and also portrait ghosts, which we do not have any of right now. We can press Y, like he said, to show the map. We are currently in the gallery, which I can't actually go up a floor. We're in the gallery right now. And also, you can press X right here. Now, the controls are a little off. It's like reversed, which is kind of... Up and down is reversed, but left and right isn't, which kind of confused me. And you can, like, click on stuff like that right there. That was nothing. Egad, how's it going?
Way to go, genius. Do you have the hang of this thing yet?
Is that supposed to be Luigi saying that? What is this?
It's a statue. A very tall angel statue by the looks of it.
Alright, Luigi. Anything else for me, Egad? Sorry to bother you.
Just looking?
No. Let's go ahead and head back to the lab.
Alright then. Where will you go, Luigi?
So now we have the option to go back to the training room or the gallery, or we can head into the mansion. Which... let's go. Let's see.
Careful now, Luigi.
And now we are inside the mansion, and you see right here, we have a toad!
Where did you go, Mario? Luigi? What? Wow! It's Luigi!
You finally made it, oh joy. Thank goodness. Me? Well, Princess Peach asked me to come here to look for Mario. He left when he heard that you'd won a mansion, and he never returned. Then when I arrived here, the mansion was full of ghosts, and I didn't see Mario anywhere, and I kind of freaked out a little, and I didn't know what to do. It's been awful. Please, please, please,
you have to help me find Mario! If he doesn't get back, you have to help me find Mario! You flip!
Goodbye. I'm so very blue. Am I supposed to say leave it to me? I feel mean. Leave it to me.
Oh, yeah. Yay!
Thank you, Luigi. You made my dark night... No, you made my dark and stormy night. And then the lights come on. I wish I could do something to help you. Wait, I've got it! At least, let me do this. Oh, he lets us save. I forgot about that. Toad is actually gonna be our save point. Now, look at Luigi's icon down there. Doesn't he look a little bit creepy? Okay. Talk to me and for any help, any time. You know what I meant. Alright, so, vacuum. We can go ahead and vacuum this thing up, and now you'll see there is a mirror right here. If we go into the Game Boy Horror... Luigi, what are you doing? What is he... That's awkward. Hit A on the mirror. It actually teleports you back to this room. Anytime you see a mirror... in the mansion, you can do that and it will teleport you back to this main room. So, that is a thing. Now, if we just go ahead and head up here... Mario! You'll see there's some gold on the floor over there. We are not going to be doing that right now. I actually just wanted to do this because there is money inside of this chandelier. Wait, come on, money. Come down with me. There we go. We can go ahead and grab all of this freaking money. And now you'll see on the bottom right there, it actually tells us... tells us how much dollar we have, so that is pretty much gonna be it for this episode. I guess I'll go ahead and why not? We'll get this money too. It's right here. Nothing inside you. We can sweep up all the spider webs too if we want to do that. We want to actually clean the mansion. That is a thing you can do. Let's get this money. Anything in you? Nothing in you. Okay. That is gonna go ahead and do it for this episode of Luigi's Mansion, the first episode. I hope you're all excited for this Let's Play. I certainly am. It was actually kind of a spur of the moment. Also, this respawned. Spooky. Spur of the moment, last minute. Oh, God, we're not done. Luigi, move! Yeah, if you do... That happens. Anyway, kind of a spur-of-the-moment, last-minute thought for this Let's Play, because I didn't really know what LP I wanted to do to replace Kirby's Adventure. Oh, God, stop! I keep forgetting that's gonna happen. But yeah, Luigi decided on Luigi's Mansion, and I'm very excited to continue this Let's Play. So, next time on Luigi's Mansion, we will be heading up these stairs once again, going through that door, and seeing if we can find any ghosts or any inkling of where Mario might be. So, I'd like to thank you all for watching. Make sure to leave a like on this video if you enjoyed, and let me know what you thought of it in the comment section below. I should probably save, because I got some money. Stay tuned for the next episode, and I will see you guys then.